Greetings. It's New Zealand naturopath Eric Bakker, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of Canxida, Candida dietary supplement range. Thanks for tuning into my video. I'm going to talk about bacteria and the digestive tract. So there are many different types of bacteria that potentially live in your GI tract. Some experts say anywhere between 300 to 400 species, some say even more. It's estimated anywhere between 2 pounds up to 4 pounds of bacteria, which is literally trillions of bacteria that populate your digestive system. So the classes of bacteria that live in your gut basically are lactobacilli, we've got bifidobacteria, we've got streptococci, we've got bacteroides, and we've got the pathogenic forms called the coliforms. Coliforms often found, for example, the polluted water can make people quite sick. So the lactobacillus and the bifidobacteria are generally known as predominantly as the beneficial ones, as the healthy bacteria. Lactobacillus tend to populate the small intestine. So there is about 5 or 6 different types of lactobacilli that I know of that are quite good for the gut. They tend to really inhabit the smaller, bowel. The bifidobacteria tend to inhabit the large bowel. If we look at a small child, for example, or one that's been breastfed exclusively, it's going to have about 99% of its bacteria will be the bifidobacteria range, and the other 1% being, the coliforms and streptococci. So each population group, depending on the age and the demographic, it really will vary the species you've got, how much you've got, what are the types of bugs you've got in your system. But everyone carries their own unique ecosystem around with them internally. So bacteria are necessary, in fact, for you to digest food. You can't really break food down without having bacteria. When you've got large amounts of beneficial bacteria, you're going to have a much more comfortable digestive system, a lot less bloating, a lot less gas. You're going to have a lot more powerful immune response, a lot less chance of leaky gut or antibody production, a lot less chance of many different types of cancers. And the acidophilin, for example, the antibiotic produced by Lactobacillus acidophilus is very anti-tumor. And so, you've got a big chance of not having a bowel cancer by having beneficial bacteria. It's going to aid you in helping you to reduce your incidence of many different chronic diseases just by having beneficial bacteria. So there's lots of reasons why you want this. But for yeast infection patients, you need large amounts of lactobacilli and bifido to crowd out the yeast. The Candida albicans is predominant in the gut. So we're going to do quite a few videos about these different types of FAQs surrounding this whole topic. So this is just really a general introductory video I've done today to explain that we're going to do a lot more videos about prebiotics, probiotics, different strains of lactobacilli. I'm going to answer a lot of your questions that I get through email and through YouTube. I get an incredible amount of questions on these topics. So I really want to go in depth and explain a lot. So feel free to ask me any questions regarding different strains or anything you might have regarding probiotics, prebiotics. And I'll do my very best to explain all these things for you. So yeah, that's a little bit about today. So catch up with me in some other videos on beneficial bacteria, probiotics in general. Thanks for tuning in.